Then I was bored in the bus, so I was just okay. Let's just try to reply lah, see what happens. We ended up married.
Hi, I'm Zack.
I'm Isni.
We met at the Esplanade.
He was an intern then. I happened to be there watching a performance and I got lost. He helped me out. And after that, like, I thought myself, maybe I should just ask him. The reason why also I asked him to help was thinking like, maybe next time I watch a show, maybe I can get discount also lah.
When she asked for my number, it's just like another patron will ask number to ask for another show.
That's all. He didn't overthink. So that was how we met lah.
Hi, I'm Amanda.
Hi, I'm Yi Liang.
We met while I was still studying and I was like asking my friends around looking for patients.
Yeah, so she then was doing dentistry. Then I also haven't really been to a dentist, so like, I don't mind lah, you know. A bit pain lah, but okay lah, yeah. I think yeah, you know, it's fine.
And that was the first time how we met.
Yeah.
It was at a dental clinic itself.
Yeah. So she cleaned my teeth.
Hi, I'm Zara.
And I'm Hafiz.
I got to know his friend first. He ended up getting my number.
But first, when I messaged, she didn't want to text me back.
Yeah. He wasn't really interesting through text. He was like, hi, I'm Hafiz, can I get to know you? And I'm like, what lah, you this guy? Then I was bored in the bus, so I was just, okay lah, just try to reply lah. See what happens. We ended up married.
When we first met also, he did talk to me. I'm still a student. Are you sure you still want me? He did ask me. I think I said, yeah, it's fine.
Once we got into marriage, that is when the financial a bit unstable because I'm a freelance worker.
We never really fight about money lah. Mostly if we have like a bit of hiccups.
Uh-huh. We can't go shopping or we don't eat out.
Mostly her lah, shopping, cutting down.
I bought you also, you buy shoes.
We graduated around the same period of time. Already from the start, Amanda earns more. If your partner is able to earn more, you know, it's a kudos to her lah. And as a partner, you should support lah.
Ultimately, when we get married, all our finances will be combined.
It's not a competition lah. It's more of like a, you know, complementing each other.
He has this condition. It's called a Stargardt's disease. So with this, their central peripheral vision is gone. He's colorblind as well.
Because of this, a lot of interview rejected me.
My late mom and late dad was very worried. Previously also with my ex also, it was the same, like he was also earning lesser than me. Then I said no, I don't see it like that. At the end of the day, it's still us and the kids.
Our friends and family didn't comment much about the pay discrepancy. Yes.
Because we were settling down at quite a young age, so they were more concerned about our combined income.
My mom would like tell Hafiz, it's okay Hafiz, even if you earn $20, you give your wife $5 or even $2, that is still money from your hard work. I don't really see anyone really like saying things like, oh, you're earning more than your husband, that's not good. I mean, if there are such people, then they shouldn't be part of your life, seriously. How's husband take care of kids, do the housework?
But
I told him if we stay at home, the chores will never finish and we don't even have kids, you know? But I told him also, if we have kids, it's okay, you stay at home. I work, I'll bring the bacon.
Yes. It's better, it's safer for me to be inside the house lah. House husband is no problem.
I mean, people have different perspectives of things. And ours is very simple, like we only care about getting things done. And there are people who feel like, oh, maybe it's their ego. Maybe they feel like, no, a wife should stay at home. That is so unfair. And a lot of women are earning more actually. Shouldn't have that kind of, the same expectation for men and women in this current situation.
Like last year, it was COVID, right? There was no events totally. He didn't earn any amount at all. So I said, okay lah, now you have to change role. I won't be doing any housework. you do everything. Yeah. He cooks and he cleans. And then when I come home, I'm not tired. Then I say, hey, you become permanent house husband also, never mind. But then after a while, I say, no, we still need extra.
At least I can do something at home. I can manage my time with my kids. When she tired or she's unhappy, at least when she come home, the house is clean. Yes. So she can relax.
Yes.
Yeah. I never think anything like as a husband lah.
Like my friends did ask me, are you alright with him staying home? They were afraid that he was taking advantage of me. Then I said, it has always been the way we live, and I never think it as that way. You don't mind, right? I mean, yeah, like, yeah, he didn't.
You want to be house husband again?
No.
Okay.
I'm bored.
It doesn't matter who stays at home. Ultimately, if it's for the good of the family, then why not, right?
Yep, everybody is starting to work and also take care of family simultaneously, because commodities are more readily available, right? Actually now, even if you stay at home, you also still can work lah. You don't do chores 24/7, right?
The future will be sharing our responsibilities.
Like she can cook, right? So yeah, she'll do the cooking lah. And then I'll compliment her by doing the dishes now. I don't want to spoil the kitchen, so yes, that. But I mean, maybe I can try sometime.
No,
can.
At home, usually, she will clean, because when I clean, she will say, hey, why you miss that spot? Because I cannot see.
We have great partnership. Every weekend, we have my nephew. We treat him like a son. So we are weekend parents. Like, he will wake up at 3 a.m. crying or what. Then he will tell me, it's okay, you see, you sleep. I take care of the baby. We share the workload together.
When I was young, my ambition was always to be a housewife, because my mom was one. But when as I grow older, I always see my mom waiting for my dad to get his money on his payday. And I didn't like it. Not because of that. I didn't want that. So I told myself, no, I must work. At the end of the day, if you are a married couple especially, it's a shared responsibility, it's shared.
These days, policies have changed. Okay, now companies have given mothers more benefits. Mothers can now go out to work, and at the same time, if there's a need to, then they can use the childcare leave to take care of their kids if anything happens.
They always expect the men to fork out first. But because I think I bring my kids up, especially my girls, they don't see it like that. They tell, it's fine, what, we go Dutch during our mother's time, like my mother's time. My mother would say, no, let him pay. I think at the end of the day, it is the mentality of the kids now. Like the way I bring up my girls is, for example, in a relationship, learn how to share and give and take.
This month, my turn, next month, your turn. give and take.
We don't have specific gender roles. We just do it together. If you can, whatever you can, you do. Whatever you need support, I help with.
People in the past usually see the norm is okay, so usually the father goes out to work and then the wife stays home to take care of the family lah. We shouldn't be sort of stuck to what it used to be, but rather look at how things have changed and see how we can adapt to the current changing environment that we all live in. Yeah.
Thank you for watching this episode, and thank you National Youth Council for making this video possible.
Do check out the link in the description for more conversations on Singapore women's development.
And if you like this video, so please like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends. Yeah, I think that's about it. Okay, bye.